Let's look at how we can calculate the effective resistance in a combined circuit. I believe you are here because you have clicked on this video. So let's go to my note screen. So we have a combined circuit here. The network of resistor is such that the 3 ohm and the 6 ohm are in parallel. And these two, 3 ohm and 6 ohm, are in series with the 4 ohm. So the logical step would be to calculate the parallel branch first. We calculate the effective resistance of the 3 ohm and 6 ohm, and then we can add this resistance to 4 ohm. Now the formula to calculate the resistor in parallel is 1 over R, where R is the effective resistance, is equal to 1 over R1 plus 1 over R2. In this case, it's 1 over 3 plus 1 over 6. And we should get 3 over 6 here. Now, please note that 1 over R will be equals to half. It's not R equals to half. 1 over R equals to half, I need to flip it around such that I get R. R will be 2.0 ohm, which means that this particular segment over here, this effective resistance over here is 2 ohm. And this 2 ohm is in series with the 4 ohm. And therefore, I can add up the effective resistance is simply 2 plus 4. And that's 6 ohm. Therefore, this whole particular segment over here is 6.0 ohm. The effective resistance of this whole thing is 6.0 ohm. And if we go back to our slides, this is what the slide is trying to explain. Basically, I work out the parallel portion first, which gives me 2 ohm, and this 2 ohm is in series with this 4 ohm, therefore 2 plus 4 equals 6. And therefore the resistance, effective resistance of the whole circuit is 6 ohm.